All right, hey everyone, welcome back to the channel. Today, we're testing out the upgraded DJI Avata with the Axis Flying 3.5-inch kit. So first flight today, haven't flown this yet. I did test it indoors, really just to make sure that it like hovered and flew properly, but that's all we did so far. So today is the first flight with the upgraded DJI Avata. We're gonna do a couple flights, but first I'm gonna test it without the DJI action on top, just to see how it goes. And then if that works out, then we're gonna put the DJI action on back on top and see how it handles it. Let's go. So normally, I would have the camera gimbal at like 35 degrees to get good, you know, speed or whatever with the Avata. So I'm gonna start off with 25 right now just to see how things go. All right. Holy crap. Well, I didn't mess it up. She flies. That's pretty fast too. Way more power. Oh yeah. What a huge difference already. All right. I'm gonna pop the Action 4 on the top. Add some weight. What's nice is this kit comes with a built-in mount for these now. Let's do it. Recording. All right. It's a little tiny breeze. I think it's less than 10 miles an hour. Super sunny. It's like 60 degrees out today. It's beautiful. It's almost like it doesn't even have anything on it. What a difference. What a difference. I'll tell you what, if you start off with the DJI Avata and you're looking to move up like to the next level, but maybe you're not ready to purchase a true FPV drone, do this upgrade. A couple reasons. Number one, it'll help you learn how to build and put together one of the normal, I guess, or traditional FPV drones. It's fairly easy to do. It was my first time. It took me about 5 to 6 hours altogether, and I followed a YouTube video meticulously, and it was easy. I didn't have any issues with it. put it all back together and works no problem. And it flies so much better. Way more power. Definitely feels more stable. Coming out of dives, it's way better. Yeah, this was a fantastic upgrade. And all in all, it costs about $150. You can get the kit on Amazon, or you can get it at getfpv.com. That's where I got mine. I'll leave a link for you guys. Yeah, this is the way to go. This is awesome. I haven't changed my rates either. So the rates are the same as what I was using before, which works out nice. I mean, everything feels really comfortable for, again, cinematic type flying, which is what I do. All my sensors are working still. T-shirt. This thing is fast now. Holy cow. Yeah. I cannot wait to get out. All right. Battery's low. All right, so yeah, guys. With the camera on there now, full is the Action 4, DJI Action 4. It does have some weight to it. This thing flies no problem, no problem at all. Flies great, super stable, has no issues with power anymore. Runs great, man. Yeah, super excited. I'm really glad I did this. It's a great upgrade. Like I said, I'll leave a link down below for anybody who's interested. I got mine at getfpv.com. I'm pretty sure that's the website. They were awesome. This actually went out the same day that I ordered it. I got it in a few days. You get points. They have this point system there. I don't know if you guys ever bought from there or whatever, but yeah, it's a great site. I'm actually looking to buy some batteries from them, because so far the service is phenomenal. But yeah, so the only thing about this kit and the upgrade is when you do this, you will not be able to access your SD card port anymore. You can't, the way it's built. So what they do is they run a USB-C extension to the bottom here, okay? So you can either use the internal memory here and you can upload your videos through here, or put an SD card in before you close everything up. Make sure it's a decent size one, right? And then you can upload and download your videos again through the USB-C port here. Or now that you upgraded this, I'd say you're gonna be using a camera on the top from this point forward, right? So you really don't need it. It's a nice backup. I didn't do it because it does have some internal memory here that's good enough for a few flights. So instead of me locking up an SD card in here forever, basically, because I don't want to take this thing apart, you're good to go. There are some videos out there where they talk about how you can see the prop guards. Unless you're flying completely flat and you're at like, you know, 0, 5, or 10 degrees on your gimbal, you can't see it. And if you're using a camera above, you can't see it either. If you're flying at 20 to 25%, you're not going to see the prop guards. Okay, so I know that was like a concern with some people with the videos that I watched, but I don't see it when I'm flying. And like I said, I fly cinematic, so low, fast, you know, stuff like that hasn't been a problem. All right, let's go. Go fly some more. So yeah, end of the day, if you're thinking about upgrading your DJI Avata with that Axis Flying 3.5-inch kit, do it. I'd say do it. Just go for it, do it. $150, get it, learn how to solder, watch the videos you need to watch, do it the right way, go slow. It's worth it. It's worth it. Also, my new drone should be here tomorrow. Big smile on my face. Can't wait. All right, guys. See you next time.